Welcome, students and staff, as well as our family joining us via live stream. It's my honor to welcome you to Norwood View's 2021 fifth and sixth grade promotion ceremony. I'm so glad you could join us for this special celebration. This has been a school year like no other. It's been the year of the C's. We began the year battling COVID, and we're ending the year battling cicadas. A special thanks to all of you for making this year a success in the face of so many challenges. Students, I'm amazed at your growth over this past year. Physically, I used to look down at you, and now I have to look up to address many of you. More importantly, emotionally, socially, and academically, you have made great strides. 9 months ago, I reminded you that as fifth and sixth grade students, you are the leaders of our student body, and I ask you to be examples for the younger students and leaders in both our school as well as the community. I'm proud to say that you delivered and you exceeded all expectations. It's been a joy to watch you mature as young men and young women. I know that your parents are also proud of your development, both as a student and as a citizen. You are a direct reflection of your family, your home, and the Norwood community. Students, I believe that you are ready for the challenges of middle school, and I look forward to hearing stories of your success. As we leave this spring and return to the View building, you will remain as new Norwood Middle School students. You have a distinct advantage in this transition because of your experience here at the middle school this year. You've already got a year under your belt. And don't forget, Ms. Brockman, Ms. Martini, and Mr. Burling will be joining you this fall in this exciting adventure. You've also had the opportunity to meet Principal Miller, and he has shared with me he is so excited to have Norwood View students come on board next year at the middle school. In essence, you are exchanging your title as a Norwood View warrior to that of a Norwood Indian. You will be missed by the View staff, but remember, Norwood View is your home, and you are always welcome to come back and visit with us anytime. At this point in our program, I would like to commence with our fifth grade awards. I would like to ask Mr. Heisel to come and distribute the fifth grade fourth quarter awards. Mr. Heisel.
I would like to welcome everybody here, and I would also like to say thank you for a fantastic year. It was difficult, but you persevered, and we really got through it. You worked hard in very difficult situation. It was like no other year in my 32 years of teaching that I've ever experienced, and I hope never to experience again. With all that said, these students were those who achieved perfect attendance for the fourth quarter in fifth grade. When I announce your name, please stand, and if you would just wait till the end and applaud at that time. Kylie Burns, Devon Dukes, Brianna Garcia, Kaylee Haas, Delvin Nolasco, Gloria Raber. Let's give a round of applause to these students. Now I'd like to recognize the students who have achieved all A's and B's for the fourth quarter. Please stand when I call your name, and just like we did, wait till the end for the applause. Emily Alexander, Kylie Burns, Kalise Cornett, Marlon Garcia, Damian Hunter, Angelie Lopez, Abby Mallon, Valerie McDone, William Nance, Gloria Raber, Jonathan Sanchez, Catherine Schaefer, Henry Thompson, and Nora Thompson. Congratulations to these students. Now I'd like to recognize the fifth graders who received all A's in every subject the entire fourth quarter. Quite an achievement. Cassidy DeBraw, Aaliyah DeVault, Brianna Garcia, Jack Giles, Alana Herbert, Kate Orza, Delvin Nolasco, Andy Thurner, and Erica Williams. Congratulations to these students. Now we'd like to recognize the students who earned perfect attendance for the entire 2020-2021 school year. These students persevered, as I was saying, that was the theme this year. Persevere and go on. And they did. They came every day. And we like to honor them right now. So please stand when I call your name. Kylie Burns, Devon Dukes, Brianna Garcia, Delvin Norlasco, and Gloria Raber. Nice round of applause. Now at this time, I'd like to turn over the mic to Mr. Burling to present the Citizenship and Presidential Awards.
Good morning to the class of 2027-2028. For years, I've been envious of the sixth grade teachers because they got to do this ceremony, and I always wanted to be a part of it because I'm going to miss you guys so much, and you've been a part of my life, and hopefully I've been a small part of yours. This year has been truly unique, and as you know, I celebrated a milestone birthday this year, and I look back on all the years of my schooling, and I can only remember little bits and pieces of each year, but I guarantee you, you will look back on this year, and you will remember a lot about it, the good and the bad, but I think mostly good. And to the parents who are watching at home, either live or on delay, I think the kids have probably handled everything that's been thrown at them better than we have. And probably the toughest part of this year has been the steps. To watch the kids every morning come up the stairs and they're out of breath and they're gasping for air, and I know what it feels like because it was killing me, but we made it through, so congratulations. I'd also like to thank the parents for sending us these amazing kids that we've had the opportunity to work with. They truly are the gold standard for Norwood, and you should be very proud. And to the kids, I hopefully very soon you'll be allowed to come back and visit us in Norwood View or the middle school and say hi. And I, believe it or not, many times if we don't recognize you immediately, I can't tell you how many times I'll be next to Miss Brockman and I'll be like, who's that? It's because not that we forget you, it's that you've matured so much. You're going to change so much over the years. So when you come up to us, please come back and visit us, and please introduce yourself again to us, because you guys are going to change so much. With that, I'd like to award the Presidential Award for Academic Excellence and Achievement from the U.S. Department of Education. The Presidential Award for Outstanding Academic Achievement is being awarded to students for receiving A's and B's in all content areas this year, making honor roll all four quarters. Very consistent. So when I call your name, please stand and remain standing until all names have been announced. Emily Alexander, Kylie Burns, Kalise Cornett, Cassidy DeBraw, Aaliyah DeVault, Brianna Garcia, Abby Mallon, Valerie McDonough, William Nance, Kate Orza, and Erica Williams. How about a round of applause for these students? And now I'd like to award the Presidential Awards of Excellence to the fifth grade. This is being awarded to students who are receiving A's in all content areas this year and making honor roll all four quarters. Very tough to do. Students, please stand when you hear your name. Jack Giles, Elena Herbert, Delvin Nalesko, and Andy Thurner. And a round of applause for these students. The next award is for this is called the Citizenship Award, and is given to students who have shown outstanding leadership and sincere kindness to their classmates throughout the year. It is an honor to recognize these students for being excellent role models, and they're an example for everyone. When you hear your name, please stand and remain standing. Emily Alexander, Kalise Cornett, and Erica Williams. And applause for these students, please. Finally, this year, many outstanding students have shown excellence in unified arts, and I would like to announce the outstanding students in each of these areas. The first one is the Art Award, and I agree with this one because this child did a lot of drawing in math class. That would be Aaliyah DeVault. The Gym Award, Travion Coleman and Kalise Cornett. And the Music Award, Kate Orza. And a round of applause for these students. And before I turn it over to Ms. McGlessick, I just wanted to say I'm excited to be going to the sixth grade next year. So I'll be following the fifth grade, and I'll be leaving two people that have meant a lot to me. I respect these two professionally, and I admire them personally. So, Mr. Heisel, Ms. McGlessick, thank you.
I get emotional. I wasn't expecting that. At this time, I will present the promotion certificates to the future class of 2028. Please hold your applause until all the names have been announced so that all the names will be heard. Emily Alexander. Rhiannon Allen. Seth Bartlett. Anthony J. Cardi. Travion Coleman. Timmy Cook. Diego Carreras, Anthony Bowling, Kylie Burns, Devon Dukes. Rico Estrada. Cartier Franklin. Kalise Cornett. Cassidy DeBraw. Kaylee Haas. Aaliyah DeVault. Brianna Garcia. Marlon Garcia. Selena Garcia. Eliana Herbert. Brianna Hidalgo Gilreath. Damian Hunter. Angelie Lopez. Abby Mallon. David Martinez. Callie May. Stephen Milford. Valerie McDonough. William Nance. Delvin Nolasco. Kate Orza. Gloria Raber. Javier Romero. Catherine Schaefer. Jonathan Sanchez. Luna Simpson. Lily Taylor. Henry Thompson. Nora Thompson. Austin Wainwright. Andy Thurner. Dante Watson. Jenna Weber. Brandon West. Olivia Whittington. Preston Wilkerson. Erica Williams. What an honor it has been to be your teacher in this strangest school year. Congratulations, the class of 2028. Please applaud. At this time, we would like to introduce the sixth grade teachers who will present those awards. Thank you.
Good morning. Now I get nervous. Got to make sure everything's in order. I do have to say that it is a bittersweet moment because Ms. Martini and Mr. Burling and myself will not be returning back to the beautiful Norwood View Elementary building that we've come to grow and love. I just was talking to Ms. Martini, and she started her career at Norwood View Elementary. I met my husband while teaching at Norwood View Elementary, who happened to go to Norwood View Elementary, and I used to stalk my in-laws who live on Hannaford Avenue. So I have a very big place in my heart for that building. So we kind of feel like a fish out of water practicing in this beautiful middle school auditorium, but hopefully we'll feel right at home next year. Please hold for just a second while I try to find our, they're not in there. I don't know. My stuff is missing. And I don't have any fun jokes to say. I do have to say, one interesting thing this year is I don't get to see their cute little faces. Mine are all missing. Because they've been masked up. So, no, that's only one. I don't know. I apologize, you guys. My script is MIA. Can go. Can we look in? I have my clipboard down there. I'm sorry, you guys. This is a big problem. You know, we rehearsed this a million times, and now we can't find the paperwork. Yeah, can we, let me see. That's not it. It might be up on Miss Martini's desk. We might be able to flip-flop and do Miss Martini's part while we find my stuff. Should I just do Miss Martini's part? She's going to find my paperwork is missing.
Well, do you want me to read hers?
Sorry, you guys. I'm going to start with Miss Martini's presidential awards and citizenship, and we'll just flip-flop the arrangement. So we're going to fly by the seat of our pants, which is kind of how we've been rolling all year. So we're going to be flexible and start with the presidential awards. So now I'm going to present the presidential awards for academic excellence and achievement from the U.S. Department of Education. The presidential award for outstanding academic achievement is being awarded to these students for receiving all A's and B's all year and making honor roll all four quarters. Please stand when your name is called, and please hold your applause until the last name is announced. Patrick Ryan, Ella Sokolis, Lucas Baldwin, Logan Bingham, Isabella Petticord, Daniel Drake, and D'Angelo Shepherd. Congratulations for these students for receiving the Presidential Award of Academic Achievement. And now I will go on to the Citizenship Award. And as Mr. Burling had said before, the Citizenship Award is given to students who have shown outstanding leadership and sincere kindness toward their classmates throughout the year. And I have to tell you, it was kind of ironic when some of my helpers in sixth grade were meandering around my desk, and a couple of them were like, well, remember when I threw that goldfish across the room? I bet you I'm not getting that award. And it was so funny because all of them had like quirky little things that they did that would have knocked them off the list. As much as I love them, unfortunately it did. But it was just so funny that they just admitted, like, oh yeah, I was bad that one day, remember? So these citizenship awards go to these people: Jabril Phillips, Daniel Drake, and D'Angelo Shepherd. Congratulations to these students in the sixth grade. Okay. Hang on just a second. I guess we will skip ahead to the promotion certificates. He only has one paper. This is so crazy. No. No. Yeah. I don't have my computer. Oh, I guess I could read it off that computer right there. No, but it's not logged in under me. It's not my computer. I can't log in under it or it'll wipe everything out. Yeah, I can. We're gonna have to work this around. Let's do the promotion certificates and then we'll come back and have to announce the fourth quarter awards. I don't know what happened to them. Is that okay, Mr. Yates? There we go.
I think it's because no one wants me to sing. But, we apologize for that. We were so organized, but you got to prepare for this kind of thing, I guess. But this class is super special. We've said that. I've told them that. We love you guys. They were just great this year handling everything. And we're really proud of you, and we're going to miss you very, very much. I'm glad you're going to be down the hall from us. At this time, I'd like to present the promotion certificates to the future class of 2027. Please hold your applause until all the names have been announced so that all names will be heard. Lucas Baldwin. Logan Bingham, Kevin Chavez, Matea Cruz, Jade Elliott, Annalise Estrada, Cameron Fiasco, Sitlali Garrido, Haven Gibbs, Kaylee Gomez, Jackson Gordon, Sean Grammer, Christina Ivory, Anthony Johnson, Ramiah Johnson, Kier Kiger Carey, Baron King, Lily King, Aubrey Lambert, Dylan Leverins Kleintank, Michaela Longelier, Chase Maxson, Angel Mendoza, Lamar Muhammad Batney, Dayan Moss, Jacob Murphy, Addison O'Mara, Haven O'Neill, Jaden Pagan LeBoy, Isabella Petticord, Jabril Phillips, Harper Raber, Cassidy Riggs, Aiden Rothschild, Patrick Ryan, Eric Sanchez Mesa, Nehemiah Seegers, Jillian Shepherd, Ella Sokolis, Ava Solano, I'm sorry. They switched names on me. Ava Solano, William Stokes, Alan Tate, Ashanti Vargas Torres, Myla Wade, Miami Ward, Mario Williams, Tegan Williams, Bryson Willis, Daniel Drake, D'Angelo Shepherd, and congratulations to the class of 2027. A very special group. What do we do? You want me to do it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thankfully, we found these, and I am very sorry because these are probably the most important. What you do for honor roll and perfect attendance, they all kind of go together, and we know you had to work through a lot of things this year with being virtual and then coming back, so we're really proud of these people. Fourth quarter, perfect attendance. They've been in attendance every day of the fourth quarter. Please stand when your name is called. We're not going to come up. And then we will applaud you. Lucas Baldwin. Logan Bingham. Chase Maxson. Angel Mendoza. Jacob Murphy. Jabril Phillips. Jillian Shepherd, William Stokes, Tegan Williams, and Bryson Willis. We may applaud them and congratulations. We would like to recognize the students who have received all A's and B's for the fourth quarter. Students, stand when your name is called, and please hold your applause until the last name is announced. We are so proud of you. Chase Maxson, Jillian Shepherd, William Stokes, Jade Elliott, Sean Grammer, Daniel Drake, D'Angelo Shepherd, Ramaya Johnson, Anthony Johnson, Baron King, Aiden Rothschild, Patrick Ryan, Ava Solano, Myla Wade, Miami Ward, Logan Bingham, Haven Gibbs, Christina Ivory, Dylan Leverins Kleintank, Jacob Murphy, Isabella Petticord, Cassidy Riggs, and lastly, Ashanti Vargas Torres. Please applaud these students. Congratulations, we're really proud of you. Now this is really a huge accomplishment. These people got fourth quarter honor roll, all A's. That's really hard to do, as we all know. We would like to recognize all of these students. Please stand up, and then we will applaud you after we're all of the names have been called. Lucas Baldwin, Ella Sokolis, Alan Tate. Congratulations. All right. Now, this is our favorite time. Get out some tissues, because one of the highlights of this ceremony each year is the opportunity to view and reflect over your journey during your last year as a Norwood View student. I think this year is extra emotional for the teachers too, because we won't be going back to View either. And although we're excited for our new chapter, we are going to miss all of our friends at the View, as you will as well. Mrs. Brockman has compiled a wonderful video to display those special moments to sit back and enjoy the presentation. Mrs. Brockman put so much work into this, heart and soul, and she gets pictures every year at the last minute, and she still puts them in there somehow. So we would like Michaela and Ella, will you please present flowers to Mrs. Brockman as a small token of all the work you do for us? We love you.
Love you, girl. Do I turn this off again?
I can remember when you fit in the palm of my hand. You felt so good in it, no bigger than a minute. How it amazes me, you're changing with every blink, faster than a flower blooms. They grow up all too soon, so let them. Cause they're only that way for a while. Give them hope, give felt so much in one little tender touch. I live for those kisses, your prayers and your wishes. And now you're teaching me how only a child can see. Tonight while we're on our knees, all I ask is please let them be little, 'cause they're only that way for a while. Give them hope, give them praise, give them love every day. Let them cry, let them giggle, let them
sleeping through from midnight till the morning. Had to crawl before you walked, before you ran, before I knew it. You were trying to free your fingers from my hand, 'cause you could do it on your own now. Somehow, slow down, won't you stay here a minute more? It's all too fast. Let's make it last a little while. I pointed to the sky, and now you wanna fly. I am your biggest fan, I hope you know I am. But do you think you can somehow slow down? To you, every missing tooth, every bedtime story. Here's to Barbie cars, lightsaber wars, sleeping in on Sunday. Had to crawl before you walked, before you ran, before I knew it. You were teaching me the only thing love can, hold hands through it when it's scary. You've got me. Let's slow down, won't you stay here a minute more? I know you wanna walk through the door, but it's all too fast. Let's make it last a little while. I pointed to the sky, and now you wanna fly. I am your biggest fan. Slow down. Please don't roll your eyes at me. I know I'm embarrassing, but some ask them if they care.
Chapter ends, a new one now begins. time has come for letting go. The hardest part is when you know all of these years when we were here are ending, but I'll always remember we have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn, the stories we will write. We have had the time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. Where the water meets the land, there is shifting in the sand, like the tide that ebbs and flows. Memories will come and go, all of these years when we were here are ending, but I'll always remember we have had the time of our lives, and now the pages turn, the stories we will write. Time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. The time of our lives, and I will not forget the faces left behind. It's hard to walk away from the best of days, but if it has to end, I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives. I'm glad you have been my friend in the time of our lives.
Well, I wonder why I'm going to miss these two classes so much and all these awards. It seems like this is the most awards we've ever handed out, or the same amount of awards, but the most students that have received those awards. It was really remarkable, and all of you students did a great job all year, and we commend each and every one of you. So in closing, I think it's only fitting that we recognize these staff members who have played such a vital role in your development. Would all staff members in the building, in the auditorium, please stand? Okay, boys and girls, look around. Let's give them a round of applause. Great, you may be seated. It is going to be unusual going back to Norwood View next fall, or probably in a few weeks, actually. We'll be moving our stuff back up there, and we will miss each and every one of you. Sincerely, from the heart, I say that. We will miss each and every one of you. And as we said, Mr. Burling and Ms. Martini and Ms. Brockman will be staying here with you, and that's got to be a great comfort for you. You know you have someone to turn to if you have any needs, especially when you first get started. Middle school is a big step. It's a big jump, and you guys are ready for the challenge, like I said earlier. And I do want to, again, recognize Ms. Brockman. She puts this whole thing together. We just get on her back and ride, because, I mean, she does all of this, puts it all together. So, Ms. Brockman, again, thanks for everything. She just has trouble finding things when she needs them. But this has been a great opportunity for us to get together one last time. And just from me to you, like I said, I will miss each and every one of you. You've been two great classes, and I know you're going to have great success in the middle school. So now, all students, would you please rise for a moment of celebration? Family, friends, staff members, I present to you the newest members of Norwood Middle School and the Norwood High School graduating classes of 2027-2028. Let's hear it.